2018 was a really good year for forecasts and for polls, including 538's forecasts, which we're very proud of. Kind of starting with the top line numbers, we had Democrats projected in the various models to win between 36 and 39 House seats. It looks like it'll be 40. In the Senate, we had Republicans picking up on average about one Senate seat. It looks like they'll win two. So again, from a top line basis, that's about as good as you can really expect. And the same goes for if you look at individual races. So we had, I think, 506 forecasts between House, Senate, and Governor. Of those, it looks like in the deluxe version of the model, about 490 will be right, again, given a couple of races that are still uncalled. What that reflects is the fact that polls had a good year. There were about as many upsets that favored Democrats and Republicans. So the Florida governor's race, for example, Gillum was ahead by a few points in the polls. He was a 75 or so percent favorite in our forecast, and DeSantis won instead. But there are several House races, Oklahoma 5, South Carolina 1, New York 11, which is on Staten Island. Those are places where Democrats won as underdogs. And so you had, you know, that's what you want. You want the toss-ups to go in both directions. When that happens, then you get to look smart. In some ways, I think the fundamentals part of our model maybe underweights a little bit partisanship. In states like Indiana, it said, oh, well, these should be toss-ups, or maybe the Democrat incumbent favored. But we're now in a political environment where the redness or blueness of the state or the district matters more than anything else. The thing I'd say about this year is, like, we're kind of tired about having the big meta philosophical arguments about forecasting. We've been doing this now for six election cycles, counting midterms, and the method basically works. It's worth remembering, though, that these things go in waves and in cycles, so you're going to have years like this one, or say 2008, you're going to have years like 2014, where everything was skewed toward Republicans relative to where the polls were. They beat their polls by 3 or 4 points on average, also 2 or 3 points in 2016, for example. And so you're going to have your better years and your worst years. We will bank this as one of our better years. We think we have a long track record now. We also think, though, that, like, you should evaluate this year's results, which were very good, in the context of the overall history of how we've done.